Hi guys, welcome to 5 Mantra. This is your ready faculty of reasoning. So today we are going to discuss a very important topic and very easy topic, that is directions, right? So this topic is almost in every exam you will get the questions from directions, because this is a practically based topic. So that is why this is very important for competitive examinations, right? So let us see those questions. Right, let us see the question. So what is the question? Again, this question is also based on the same data. If M is 1 kilometer to the southeast of L, then it is exactly midway between is given. So if you observe, this diagram is important for this question. So let us draw clearly this one. So first diagram and drawing same thing again here. One line you can take for easy understanding. So this is Y. And this is K. The distance between K and Z is 30 kilometers from here to here, 30. And this total is given 50 from here to here, 50 kilometers. That means this is Y and Z. If you take this Y and Z, this becomes 20. Because that is 30, this is 20. And next thing is clearly given. L is there, or H is there, H direction is given. Suppose this is H, which is given 38 kilometers from Y. So this is 20, means this is 18. Then this total becomes 38. Is it clear now? This is 38. Right? And one more is given, L, which is 14 kilometers from H. So this is 14 kilometers west. This 18 is from year to year, 18, and this is 40 from year to year, you have 40. That is H is given, that is L is given here. This is the exact diagram, and this is 4. Total becomes 18. 4 plus 4, 8. Now the question is, what is given? If M is 1 kilometer to the southeast of L. So southeast means this is the direction. So that side, L, that is M, is 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer means somewhere here you have 1 kilometer. This is M. Right? So now is asking, then it is exactly midway between, is asking. So observe here, what is the distance of this YM? YM from here to here. What is the distance becomes? That is your two. That is up to here 20 plus 24 plus 1, 25. This total becomes 25 kilometers, Y2. Is it clear? Y2, this, that is Z, it is already 20 kilometers, and Z to L, 4 kilometers, L to M, 1 kilometer. So total becomes 20 plus 4 plus 1, 25 kilometers. So this is 25 kilometer means, what about this, this distance, M to K? That is also 25 kilometers, because the total distance is 50 kilometers only. So half of the distance is this one, remaining half is that. So 25 kilometers, 25 kilometers. So that M is exactly between, or midway between Y and K. If you observe the options, so exactly midway between Y and K, that becomes the correct answer. No doubt in that, right? So second option becomes the correct. Is it clear? So let us see the next one. The distance from G to H is asking. So this is also simple if you observe. G to H. Just now you find the distance. G to H already find, because of that you are getting 26 kilometers, right? Then you will get the answer as 52 minutes. So G to H is asking. Where is the G is taken? Exactly midway between this one. So midway between L and Y. So 24 means this is 12. This total is 24 from here to here. L to Y, this is 24. 24 means here 12. So out of 20, here you have only 20 up to here. This is 20, all it is 12 means this is 8. Now is asking distance between G and here you have G. G and what is asking? H. So G and H is nothing but this is 8, this is 18. 8 plus 18, 26 kilometers, which is first option. Is it clear? So no need to calculate anything. That is directly from the diagram. So again, this is based on facing each other or turn 90 degrees, 30 degrees is here. Let us see that. A man is facing south. For example, you can take one line. I first read the question. Man is facing south. He turns 135 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction and then 180 degrees in the clockwise direction. Which direction is he facing? So the question is very easy here. Suppose you can take one arrow. First, it is facing in south. Suppose this is the arrow we can take which is facing in south. He turns 135 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction means this is the anti-clockwise direction. So 135 degrees means if you take up to here, this is 90 degrees, right? This is the position, you will get 90 degrees. So this is 90. So from here again 45 degrees you have to move. If you move 45 degrees, that represents 135 degrees. So 45 degrees means here you will get 45. Now this total becomes 135 degrees from here to here, 135 degrees. That is completed. Next one is, and then 180 degrees in the clockwise direction. Clockwise direction means this is the direction from here to here. This is the clockwise direction. And observe is given 180 degrees. 180 degrees means from exactly this position, straight line you will get. See here. Like this, if you take a straight line, that is, this is moving from here to here. This degree is 180 degrees. Is it clear, all of you? First, this is south facing. After that, it moves 135 degrees anti-clockwise direction. From there, again, it is moving 180 degrees clockwise direction. Now, is asking what is the direction of this final arrow. Is it clear? So, this direction, which direction indicates this is? So, if you take the original diagram, this is the arrow, right? This arrow indicates which direction? So this is north, this is west, and this is south. So answer becomes southwest. This is the arrow indicates southwest. That is fourth option. Is it clear? Nothing is there. Just you can move the arrows according to the given data. Right? Let us see the next question. So again, same one more is given. A man is facing northwest. He turns 90 degrees in the clockwise direction and then 135 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction. Which direction is he facing now? So you can observe here, same diagram, or you can take one more diagram. So first I am writing, man is facing northwest. Otherwise you can write directly, northwest. So, you know already northwest means which direction? East, sorry, north, south, east, west. These are the directions. So, it's clearly mentioned that he is facing northwest. So, northwest means this is the direction. He turns 90 degrees is given. Suppose this is the original position, northwest, from here. Now, he turns 90 degrees in the clockwise direction. 90 degrees means, suppose if you take this is the point, this is 45 degrees, one more 45 degrees you can consider. This is the arrow mark. So, 45 plus 45, 90 degrees. This is the position. Is it clear? Because clockwise is given, we are moving in this direction. This is the original position, moves 90 degrees means exact you will get. So, this is another one. So, this is the position of our man. Next, and then 135 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction. 135 degrees, observe here, this is a straight line. At this position to this position already 90 degrees, is it clear? from year to year 90. We want 135 means one more 45. So 45 means this is 45. Exactly this indicates the arrow. 45, 45, 90 plus one more 45. That is nothing but 135. So this is the position of arrow. Final position of arrow is this direction. So this indicates which direction here. So that is west. So if you observe the options, that is second option. Nothing is there, right? Just you can draw the given diagram according to that given question. Simple thing. First 90 degrees is in northwest position. 90 degrees. After that again 135 degrees in anti-clockwise direction. So that becomes the west direction. Next. So again this is also given. A man is facing towards west and turns to 45 degrees in clockwise direction. Let us see. And again 180 degrees clockwise and then turns through 270 anti-clockwise. Which direction is he facing? Right? So same question again you can take. This is given RRB 2005 given. Simple question these are, right? But they are asked exam compulsory. These questions are simple. The same time they will ask in the examination. So let us take one more arrow here. So man is facing towards west is given. Towards west means this is the direction, west direction. Next, and turns through 45 degrees clockwise. Clockwise means this is the clockwise direction, 45 degrees is given. So let us take one more arrow which represents 45 degrees. This is the position, for example, 45 degrees position. Here you are getting this arrow, 45 degrees. This indicates 45. Next one. Again 180 degrees clockwise. So in from this position 180 degrees clockwise. Clockwise means again same direction is moving. I told you just now 180 degrees means that indicates straight line. So straight line means here you will get. Like this arrow you will get here because this total becomes 180 degrees. From here to here this is 180 degrees. That is complete. Next, and then turns 270 degrees anti-clockwise direction. From this position again 270 in anti-clockwise direction, that is reverse direction. From here to here already that is 180. We are moving in this direction now. This direction we are moving. So this is already 180. We want 270. So 180 plus how much you will get? 270. If you are 90 degrees, that becomes 270. Is it clear? So 180 plus 45. One more 45 we required. So here you can take 45 degrees. This is the position of the arrow. Now this total indicates 270 degrees. Is it clear, all of you? First it is facing west and turns 45 degrees. This is the position. From here again 180 degrees in clockwise direction. This is the position of the arrow. And from here again 270 degrees in anti-clockwise direction. So finally you are getting arrow here. Right? So now he is asking which direction is he facing now. So this is which direction? Arrow is like this, right? So this is west, this is south, north, east. So this direction indicates southwest. So answer becomes southwest arrow. This indicates southwest. So that is fourth option. Is it clear? Right? Let us see the next one. So I am facing east, I turn 100 degrees in the clockwise direction and then 145 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction. Which direction am I facing now? Now here also is asking only direction. So let us draw the diagram. So this is one of the previous question, which is given 1998. This is the question given 1998, hotel management question. Simple questions, right? So let us see that. So first, I am facing east is given. So take one east side. So facing east, this is completed. Next, I turn 100 degrees in the clockwise direction. Clockwise direction means this is the clockwise direction. So 100 degrees, if you observe, this is 90 degrees, just beside 90 you will get 100. So I am drawing like this. Not exactly 90, this becomes 100. Is it clear? This angle is 100 degrees. From here to here you are getting 100. Next one. And 145 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction means reverse direction. First we are moving in clockwise direction. Now in anti-clockwise direction 145 degrees. So let us move 145 degrees. Already know that from here to here 100. 100 degrees is completed. 45 degrees means you will get somewhere here 45. Half of 90 will become 45, right? Like this you will get arrow, which indicates this is 145 degrees in anti-clockwise direction, that is reverse direction. Which direction am I facing now? So this is which direction is asking. Just now explained, this is the direction of the arrow. So always you can check like this only. So this is north, this is east. So it becomes northeast. This arrow indicates northeast. That's all. Is it clear? So which option it is? Second option. Right? So this is basic diagram for all. This is very, very important. Right? Let us see the next one. Right? So in this way, we can do so many questions in directions, because this is very, very important. So in next class we will discuss more concepts on, that is more advanced concepts in directions. How will they ask the questions based on the directions? So those questions we will discuss in the next video. And one thing, don't forget to subscribe. This is UK Ready signing off.